2 weeks ago, we had Robin de Groot in the studio, and so they finished second, but like I said earlier, an hour and 18 minutes behind you guys. Were there times when her team really pushed you?
I mean, we always felt them in our neck. We just really focused on a very, very good start. Obviously then on stage three, when they were ahead of us, we had to make sure that we overtake them as soon as possible and actually get away from them as soon as possible. I mean, they're very good quality riders. One thing to say is also, I mean, they've done a lot of stage racing already together. Mm. They're a very well-matched team.
She also has a Scandinavian partner.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it's quite interesting. Yeah, but they also just know how to race a stage race, and that's very important. I think that's something that you just kind of need to learn a little bit. I've done so many stage races before with Eric, and yeah, I really got a lot of experience in it, and I definitely think that helps us a lot, how to race it.
The women's race, it doesn't seem to be almost as competitive as the men's race. I don't know if that's true or not. I just guess in terms of, I mean, the gap between you guys in second place is huge, whereas in the men's race, it's a lot tighter.
Yeah.
Do you think that's going to change?
Yeah, definitely. I actually didn't expect it to happen like that. It was also very unfortunate because a lot of teams actually had to pull out. There was Gunrita Dahl's partner, Katrin Steenemann, she got sick. Milena Lantwing got sick. Sally Bigham's original partner, Blaža Klemenčič, who would have been also very, very strong, had to pull out even before the race.
Okay.
And then the actual partner that she raced with also had to pull out because of a heat stroke, I think. So there was a lot of unfortunate things happening that actually made the ladies' competition probably a bit less in the racing. There's just still less teams, you know, the depth is not quite as big as in the men's, and I just think it just takes time. You know, we already have, they said something like 50 teams was it last year, and now it was 100 ladies' teams, so it doubled in 1 year.
Okay.
Just after putting the actual prize money from Sasol equal. It just takes time. And you know, also in the men, so many teams, you know, pull out, but there's still many left that really can go for the overall title. So it just needs more numbers, and I really, really hope more and more of the ladies out there come and do this race.
And just final question, it's also something I asked Robin. We know that the entrance fee for the Apps Cap Epic is you know, is ludicrous. It obviously helps guys like you who've got sponsors. But how is the Epic always going to be, excuse me, like a sort of elite event? How do the organizers plan to make it a bit more accessible to the average mountain biker? Because I see next year's race, the early bird entries were gone within like 7-9 minutes or something crazy.
Yeah, that's unfortunately how it is. And I actually think for the sport, it needs to be like that. I mean I'm a professional racer, and I'm extremely thankful for the Absa Cape Epic that they really actually put the racing first. There's just, it needs to have one race that really is about the racing, where everybody wants to compare themselves with the world's best mountain bikers. I mean, the Absa Cape Epic really gets the world's best people here to this race, and it's almost like a unique opportunity to measure yourself with the best. But there's so many other beautiful races in South Africa, like the Wynns to Wales, like the Cape Pioneer, where it's much more about the average rider. And I mean, you can choose your race depending on what you want to experience. And I think the Absa Cape Epic is just the one race where you really race against the top people in the world, and where it's really about the racing. And I think it just pushes our sport so much more forward, and I'm very happy that it actually is like that.
Okay. So just quickly, what's next for you?
Now
and Annika, or do you only meet again at the next Epic?
No, we see each other at Marathon World Champs in Italy. It's end of June. So that's my next big goal that I'm training for. But on the way, I've got a national marathon in Clarence from the National Marathon Series. And Yeah, the Sony 2C and also my Swiss Marathon champs in Switzerland.